So, good morning students. So we come to the lesson. We are going to discuss a types of sets. In the types of sets, first we see that is a empty set, which we also call it as a null set. So null set means what? A set which does not, which have no element. Simply we can say no elements. Yavudu element illa. Set again antevi now empty set antevi or null set. ಅದನ್ನು ಎದರ್ಲೇ ಡಿನೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿನೋಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಬ್ರೇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಲವರ್ ಬಕೆಟ್ ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ನಲ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದನ್ನು ಸಿಂಬಾಲಿಕಲಿ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಈ ಥರ ಪಾಯ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ನಲ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ರೋಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ರೋಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಹೆಂಗೆ ರೀ ನಮಗೆ ಯಾವುದು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಸಿಗ್ಲಾದಂಗೆ ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಸೊ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ರಿ ವೇರಿಯೇಬಲ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಬಲ್ನ ಬರೆದು ಆ ವೇರಿಯೇಬಲ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆ ವೇರಿಯೇಬಲ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಬಂದಿರಬಾರ್ದು ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಎನಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದಟ್ ವೇರಿಯೇಬಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ ಟು ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ ಟು ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಪ್ರೈಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ ಟು ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಎನಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ರೂಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟೆಡ್ So for the variable, then it is called as a null set. Similarly, we have taken the another example that x is a natural number less than 1. So it does not have any natural number less than 1. One kitta kadimi iruvanta yavu natural number illri. Yavu natural number illandre namage yavu element sigilla. Yavu element sigilla andre null set. So these are the two examples for the null set. So next we move to that is the So next we come to that is a singleton set. Singleton set means a set having only one element. A set having only one element is called the singleton set. Singleton set. So can you give an example for the singleton set? Singleton set example kodonre. So we have that is two types of example for the singleton set. That is x equal to 1. Only one element, a set which containing only one element is called. This is a singleton set. And 2, it is a singleton set. So 3, 7, 9. So these all are called as a singleton set. And in which form they are? In which method we have? So they are in the roster method. Yav method ne kadavri now singleton set baradudu roster method ne kadav. E singleton set na set builder ne barak baratri. So we can write that. Let me take a single term that is root 2. Only one. So instead of writing 2, we have to write in a set builder for means variable we have to consider. So let x. So for this x we have to apply or we have to write a specific property for that which from which we get that is the 2 only. Now hang baribekri property andra a property in the namage en barbekri 2 one element barbek. So we should get the only one element from that property. So which is that property? So x is a even prime number. So even prime number. Which is a even prime number we have that? So only one number we have. Prime numbers we know that which are greater than 1. 1 kita jaasti irabekri. Matt enagutri tannan taane divide aagutri. Matt 1 irle divide. ಇವು ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವ ಸೊ ಅದರೊಳಗೆ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ನಂಬರ್ 2, 3, 5, 7 ಸೊ ಆನ್ ಹೌದ್ರಿ ಇದ್ರೊಳಗೆ ಇರುವ ಈವನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಯಾವ್ದು ಇದ್ರಿ 2 ಒಂದೇ ಸೊ ಒಂದೇ ಬಂತೇನ್ further. So that is x. X is a even prime number. So we from this property, idu property ni. ಈ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಒಂದೇ ನಂಬರ್ ಸಿಕ್ತು, ಅದು ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ಟನ್ ಸೆಟ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ರೋಸ್ಟರ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡರ್, ರೋಸ್ಟರ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡರ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ಟನ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್, ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ರೋಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಲೆಟ್ ವಿ ಟೇಕ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ X is a prime number between 2 and 5. So what they have given the property, X is a prime number between 2 and 5. Which are the prime numbers? Those we have to know. Yav prime number ri avu gottirbeku. So yav yav ri prime number namaga gottiddudu 2 3 5 7 11 13 17 like this we know that. In that, in between 2 and 5, which are the prime numbers in between 2 and 5? 2 matta 5 nadavakiru prime number yavudre, that is 3. So that is equal to. So this is a way of expressing that is a roster to the set builder, set builder to the roster. Take the example for. So next we come to that is the what we mean by the cardinal number. Cardinal number means number of elements present in a set. Cardinal number andre endre number of elements. So in the set, number of elements of the set we call. Suppose if we have a set A, A is a set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the set. So then how many elements are there in this set? 5 elements are there. So how we write that is, how we represent means N of A, we will write that. This is called as a cardinal number of A. N of A in Bhattavarudhya is a cardinal number. Cardinal number andre endre number of elements present in a set. Number of elements in the set or present in a set. So how many elements are there? So 5. We'll write that is N of A is equal to 5. So this is called as a cardinal number of a given set. Suppose for 1 marks they may ask that is what is the cardinal number of the A set. So they will give the set. And they will ask to write that is what is the cardinal number. Cardinal number means number of elements in the set A. Number of elements in the set A. How many elements are there in a set A? The number of elements. Elements of a set is called the cardinal number. And it is represented by N of A. If A is any set, then basically N of A. So that is a cardinal. Example told only. Example that A is a set. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So this is the set we have. So what is the cardinality of this set? Either the cardinality is 3. So yes, the elements are the NS worker. How many elements are there in this set? The number of elements of a set. Yes, the element are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that is n of A is 8. N of A is 8. So the number of elements in a set A is 8. So next we are defining the some more types of sets on the basis of the cardinality of a set. So for example, equal set, there also we need the number of elements. Next, finite set, infinite set. Finite set means what? Finite andre enu? Finite andre enu? Finite andre lekka hakak barabodu. So that the set which containing a countable number of elements, the set which containing the countable number of elements, and then now count madak baruvanta ast elements iddu andre set nodu adukke en antivi, so finite set. So if it is infinite means uncountable number, and the count madlak varladashtu number iddu andre, so that is called as a infinite set. For example, if we return any set like this, if A is a set, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on, 2. So this is. So how much we can count here? So it is not end. End ilel, infinite and so that is an infinite set. And then count madak barudha. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 100, 200, 300, 500, 1000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crore, 10 crore, so billion, trillion, like this we get. So last we will get the trillion. So up to trillion we can read. So then after that we cannot read that. Means more than that we have a number here. So for that, so we can call it as an infinite set. So infinite set andre endre uncountable number of elements, a set which have containing uncountable number of elements, then it is called as an infinite set. Finite set means the set which countable number, means the cardinality is finite. Cardinality en irbekre nam lekka hakashte irbo, so which we can count them, so then they are called as a finite. So this is example for the finite set. Why? Because we can count them. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So how many we have? That is 8. They are countable. So then it is called as a finite set. Here it is uncountable. Yestadavo ant helakagudulri. Elli matta adavo annodu helakagudulri. So then if I restrict this up to 100. So now it is a finite set. If you not return that is end, then it is an infinite. Yakri andre? ಕೌಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲರಿ. ಕೌಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಬರುವಂತ ಸೆಟ್ ಗೆ ಫೈನೈಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ. ಕೌಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಬರಲಾದಕ್ಕ ಇನ್ಫೈನೈಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಫೈನೈಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಫೈನೈಟ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಸೀ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ಫೈನೈಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಫೈನೈಟ್ ಸೆಟ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಕಮ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್, ಫೈನೈಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಫೈನೈಟ್ ಸೆಟ್. In that first we say about the finite set. Finite set andre endri. Finite set andre endri. One, so finite number of elements irbo. Athwa countable number of elements irbo. The set having the finite number of the set having the finite number of elements is called the finite set, called the finite set. So next we come to that is an infinite set. Infinite set and really the set having the infinite number of elements. The set finite number of elements. Number of elements. Elements is called the infinite set. So this is about the finite set and infinite set. So can we take an example for the finite set and infinite set? So first, for the finite set, example for the finite set. So for the finite set, we'll take an example. Finite set. Example thodu okay. So we can give that if A is a set, for example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have a finite number of elements here. So then it is called as a finite set. It is a finite set. So next, for infinite set. Infinite set. Then B is equal to infinite set. So B enagutre A. So for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, so on up. So it is called as a infinite set. Why? Because it has a infinite number of elements. Equal set means to make a equality of a two sets, or we need that two sets. Erdu set bekagutre yavade compare equal andre compare madodaitre. So equal is nothing but the comparison. Comparison madbekadre namge yav ena comparison madbekadre erdu vastu bekri athwa erdu objects bekri erdu elements beku. Illi navu equal sets bagge kalakatevi andre erdu set bek. We need the two sets. So when we say that two sets are said to be an equal set, yavaga heltevri erdu set equal adavu andre. So if the number of elements of both the sets should be same, and they should have a same elements. Number of elements are same irbekre, same elements irbe. Elements are same and number of elements should be same. Then we say that is an they are the equal set. So let's the two sets A and B are said to be a equal set if and only if one is there, if and only they, the sets A and B have the same elements. Same element. Nodri if and only if eduk bardini andre eradu kade vaisa varsa annangre. So equal agbekadra idu agirbeku. Ivu eradu iddu andre equal irthaiti anna. Onda side illri eradu side hold should agutre anna. If the sets A and B have the same, eradane idenri the sets and B have the same number of element, have the same number of elements. Have the same number of elements. So examples kodunri. Let me take that is A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. B is equal to 4, 3, 2, 1. So equal side means the two sets A and B are said to be equal sets if and only if. First condition is that the sets A and B have the same elements. In condition re same elements irbutre. The set A and B have the same number of elements. If yeradu condition satisfy maditu andra avuke en antevri equal sets. So example tondevri A anadu ond example 1 2 3 4. B anadu 4 3 2 1. So in this set if we are writing the elements, the order is not important here. But they should be distinct. Distinct is the order hangara irre. So they are considered as the elements of the set and they are said to be in a set. So here we have to confirm whether they are equal or not. Equal or not we have. So A have the how many elements we have? 4. Here also 4 elements. Means they have the same number of elements. Same elements is there. 1 is there. 2 is there. 3 is there. 4 is there. So means A and B have the same number of elements. A matu B in adore same number of elements adore same elements adore. So A equal to B. A equal to B. So next we come to the another type of a sets, equivalent set. It is not a equal, equivalent set, equal or equivalent. So when we say that two sets are equivalent set, if they have the same number of elements, only one condition it should satisfy. Yavag equivalent set antheri andre as eradu set olaga yen irbekre number of elements same irbeku. Remaining it does not matter whether they have same elements iddu andre equal agutte. So bare number of elements same iddu andre en antevri equivalent set. The two sets A and B are said to be a equivalent set if they have the same number of elements. Same number of elements. If we say that is A and B are equivalent set. If condition is N of A is equal to N of B. We are doing equal in the equivalent set. Example for only. So let me take an example. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. B is equal to A, B, C, D. So whether they are equivalent set? So yes, they are equivalent set. Because here also we have 4 elements. Here also have four elements. So we say that A and B are equivalent set. Equivalent set. Equivalent sets. So here we have to study that is the next type of a sets, that is a subset. Subset means what? Sub means what? That we have to understand. So sub means it is a part of that. For example, this is a college. What we are? We are the part. Means we are in the. So present in the college. Means we are the subsets of the college. College is a set. That is a set of this. And in that, first year students are the, so they are the collection of the first year students. So it is a set. But the collection of all the students of the college is in a whole set. In that we have a first year students, means the first year students are the parts of the college, means they will become a subset of that. So here if we have a two sets, from that we are going to define how to define the set. So let I take that is 1, 2 and 3 is a set, and we have another set B, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are the two sets. So now if you observe that, so A is a set 1, 2, 3 and B is another set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let me observe, these are the elements, 1, 2, 3 are the elements of A. So whether these elements is there in B, is there. So then what we say that, so these are the parts of this, means A is a set which is a part of B. So then what we say that A is a subset of B. Then how we write that is in a symbolically form is like this. A is a subset of B. So when we say that A is a subset of B, means every element of A set. Iliruvanta ella element ellirbekri B idage. Every element of a set A are the elements of the set B. Then we say that A is a subset of B. ಯಾವಾಗ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಬ್ಸೆಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವ್ರಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತ ಎ ದೊಳಗೆ ಇರುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿರ್ಬೇಕ್ರಿ, ಬಿ ದಾಗ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್, ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ. ಇಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ, ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟ್ರಿ ತೋತೀನಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್, ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಊರಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಎದುರಾಗ A that A nara, then X belongs to B. Then so A that element, if we have that in a B, A that element for all X belongs to A, then X belongs to B. Andre A dolo giru anta ella element ella namu gothaitre B dagu adam avaga yenantiri A is a subset. This much about the subset. So this is the last. So that is the types of sets. Still some more we have, that is a power set. Later we will study about that power set, how it is defined, the power set. So we will see. So first we understand about the subset. Subset and read it. Every element of a set A are the elements of a set B. Then we say that it is a subset of B. So let me take the definition of that. ಡೆಫಿನಿಷನ್ ತೋಡಿ, ಇಫ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಫೈನೈಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ is said to be a subset of B. A is said to be a subset of B if every element, every element of A. A ದೊಳಗಿರುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಆರ್ ದಿ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ಅವಾಗ ನಾವು ಏನಂತೀವಿ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎ ಸಬ್ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನ ಹೆಂಗ್ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ represented by like this A is a subset of B A is a subset of B idan symbolically heng bareyutevri now so without writing these words we can also say that A is a subset of B heng bareyutevri so A is a subset of B if yavaga antare A the subset yavaga if for all x belongs to A then A nirvakri x belongs to B andre A dolage iruvanta prati ondu element ellalavri B idaga navu andre andre avaga enagutre A is a subset of B so we can write that is a subset like this also ಈ ತರನು ಬರೀಬೋದ್ರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಎನಿ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ದಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎ ದೆನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ದಾಗ ಇರುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಗೊತ್ತೈತ್ರಿ ಬಿ ದೊಳಗು ಅದಾವ ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರಿ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು A, B, C, D, E, F. ಅದ್ರಿ ಹಾ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಎ ದೊಳಗೆ ಇರುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಬಿ ದೊಳಗದವ್ರಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸಬ್ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸಬ್ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸಬ್ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬಿ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ So these are the types of sets which we have completed. Now we have to solve the examples regarding first that is about the set. So how to identify the set? We came to know that set is nothing but the collection of well-defined objects, distinct objects. So they will give the collections, they will give the statements, those collection, in those collection we have to identify whether it represents a set or not. If a given collection is well defined then we have to state it as an a set if the given collection is not definite so collection is not well defined not well defined means indefinite so then it is not called a set so examples on these sets we completed next types of representation we have studied so there are two types of representation we have one is roster method and another one is set filter method So in those two types of representation, transforming of one set to another form. So those we have to study. Next, after that we have studied that is the study that. So types of sets: singleton, null set, singleton set. Next, finite set, infinite set, equal set. So and equivalent set. So next, finally we came to that is the subsets. So these are the types of sets in that we came to know the cardinal number so they will give the number elements so they will give the elements of the sets and they will ask you that how many elements are there in the given set they will give the sets like this and they will ask you to find out the number of elements in that set those ideas would be there number of elements in a given set is called as a cardinality of that set adakke enantare cardinality of a set so this concept we have already studied so tomorrow we will start the examples regarding this whatever we have studied so up to this types of sets first set and representation of sets and types so on these three aspects So we are going to discuss the examples regarding these three aspects. So we will stop here and tomorrow we will start the continuation of this part.